There's a question which came up in Zach previously. It's a pretty interesting one on averages. Professor B noticed something peculiar while entering the quiz marks of his 5 students into a spreadsheet. The spreadsheet was programmed to calculate the average after each score was entered. Professor B entered the marks in a random order and noticed that after each mark was entered, the average was always an integer in ascending order. The marks were this. This is not the order in which he entered. This is the ascending order of marks. What were the 4th and 5th marks that he entered? So the spreadsheet program is something like this. You enter the first mark, it will give you the average of 1 mark. That is okay. You enter the second mark, it will give you the average of these 2 marks. If you enter the third mark, it will give you the average of these 3 marks. Then the 4th mark, it will give you average of these 4. And 5th one, that will be the average of these 5. Okay. Now, after he enters the 5th mark, what is the total? The total will be sum of all this. That's 162 plus 82, 44, 324, 400 is the total, right? Which means the second last mark that he entered, before he enters the last mark, this number is also an integer. This average is also an integer, which means this number should be a multiple of 4. So from 400, take out a number so that the remaining will be a multiple of 4. Now 400 itself is a multiple of 4, which means the number entered last is also a multiple of 4. So it can be either 76 or 80, right? So this is out. So the last mark cannot be 82. Last mark has to be 80 or 76. From the given options, only 80 is available, right? Which means till here it's 320. Now, if I follow the same logic, if I remove the 4th mark, whatever left over should be a multiple of 3. If I subtract 71 from this, let's go by the options. If I subtract 71 from this, this gives you 249, which is a multiple of 3. 320 minus 76 will give you 244, which is not a multiple of 3. And 320 minus 91 gives you 229, which is also not a multiple of 3. So this is fine. 71 will be, this mark will be 71, right? So option B is your correct choice. Right? Pretty interesting question, but key point here is understand what the spreadsheet does and then use the options to solve them. That finishes this question.